Hello, my name is Maria and this is Mathy, my mascot. In this lesson, we're going to study about counting change. And we're going to use the method of counting up to find the change. And let me show you how. Let's say that somebody buys a cup of coffee for 78 cents. And they give a dollar. Now you remember that the change is how much you are overpaying. It is the difference between this and this amount. And for counting up, we will start with this smaller amount, 78 cents, and we will count until we reach $1. Okay? And this is how it happens. From 78 cents, I will first count up to 80 cents using two pennies. Okay? A penny and a penny would go from 78 to 80 cents. And then from 80 cents, I go to 100 cents, or $1, using two dimes. Okay? So now I have counted up to $1, and this is the change. It is 22 cents. Let's try it again. Here's a set of pencils, cost 66 cents. Again, the customer gives $1, or 100 cents, to pay for it. And now we start counting from 66 up towards 100. So 66, first you want to use some pennies to go to 70. Okay, let's take 4 pennies. That would make 70. Then from 70, I can go 10, 10 and 10, right? Or a dime here, another and another. And now that goes from 70 to 80 to 90 to 100. And so this is my total change. 34 cents. Over here, comb that costs $1.05. The customer gives $1.25, would be a $1.25. And again, we can count up. We can also, if you can, figure it out. Just look at the difference of these two numbers. I can see that the difference is 20 cents. So that is the change, right? And if you're counting up, that will work too, from 5 cents to 15 and then to 25 cents. Some strawberries. Mathy, are you hungry? Yeah, he's hungry for strawberries and blueberries, he said. $3.40. Customer gives $5. Okay, so we need to count up again, starting at $3.40. First, I will count up to the next whole dollar, which is $4, okay? So from $3.40, I will add 60 cents, and that will take me to $4, right? Let's draw here 60 cents, okay? Maybe you would use 2 quarters, would be 50 cents, and then 10 more, so that's 60 cents. And now we add $4, and then $1 more to go to $5, and $1, maybe you would use a $1 bill. And that is the change, so we get $1.60. Right? $1.60. Okay, next we have a beach ball, $4.28. The customer gives $5. Now try to work it out yourself. Pause the video. Or try to be quicker than I when I work through it. $4.28. First, I will add from 28 to 30 cents. That means 2 pennies. Okay? 30 cents. Then I will add a 10 and a 10. I will be at 50 cents. $4.50. And then from $4.50, I add 50 cents to go to the next whole dollar. So 50 cents. Oh, this could be 2 quarters too. So in total, the change is 72 cents, right? A book, $7.85. Oh, Mathy is telling me that make it to be a math book. Yes, okay, math book. And the customer will be Mathy, right? Mathy buys it, $7.85. The customer gives $10, okay? Let's work it out together again. From 85 cents, we go to 90 cents first, right? add 5 cents to that. We add 90 cents. Then add 10 cents, and we are at the next whole dollar, at $8, okay? From $8 to $10, we would need $2. A dollar and another. So this is our change. This is the change Mathy gets. $2.15. And lastly, a nice t-shirt. $6.95. The customer gives $10. Can you figure it out once again on your own? 95. Add 5 cents, right? And then you are at $7, at the next whole dollar. And from $7 to $10, $3. So 3 of these. There. The change is $3 and 05. Notice we need to put a zero here if we always have to have 2 digits for the cent amount. Okay, well done with this lesson.